serving Bucks County for 30 years, this is WBCB-AM, 1490 on your radio dial.
Happy, happy birthday, baby.
Johnny Mack, you've heard the voice, you don't see the face very often, maybe it's just as good that you don't. I do the Sunday afternoon show on WBCB, I've done it for a few years, 12 to 6 you might say, on a Sunday afternoon. It's my pleasure to bring you the big band sounds, I love them. I hope you noticed that little influence of Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers in a couple of those tunes that Francis Albert did. I'm referring to Let's Face the Music and Dance, and also You'd Be So Easy to Love. Face the Music was an Irving Berlin tune, and Cole Porter wrote Easy to Love, but they were both featured in Fred Astaire, Ginger Rogers movies, and if you expect me to name the movies, forget it. They made so many of them, it's kind of hard to track them down. But the music, yeah, it reminds me a lot of Fred and Ginger and those great combinations that they had of dancing and singing and romancing together. WBCB reminds you that Bucks County Technical School will hold their open house on Wednesday, November the 18th from 7 to 9 p.m. The technical school is located on Worcester Road in Fairless Hills. The weatherman is saying sunny this afternoon with the highs near 60, then clear tonight. There could be some patchy fog toward morning with lows in the mid-30s, and then tomorrow mostly sunny with the highs in the mid to upper 50s. So it seems to be getting just a little bit cooler each day, but still beautiful weather and sunshine, and you couldn't ask for much nicer weather than what we've had the last couple of days. Let's hope it stays that way for a while. Right about the 12:30 mark, we like to reach back and play one of the old big band numbers that Frank Sinatra was featured in. And you may recall, that goes back to the Tommy Dorsey days, when Frank used to sing with Tommy Dorsey and had on the bandstand there with him quite an alignment of vocal talent like Joe Stafford and Connie Haynes and the Pied Pipers. And here we go with Sinatra without the pipes and without Connie and without Joe, but not without talent, and he was showing that very early on when he did a number like this one a beautiful ballad with the Tommy Dorsey Orchestra in the Blue of Evening. I remember when we first started on the air back on December the 8th, 1957, we started out on a Sunday, and I remember that Tom Early and I were there together, along with a number of other names that are no longer associated with the station. I remember the first voice on the air for WBCB was a fellow by the name of, from Philadelphia's WIBG, the Mellow Meadow Mayor from Magnolia Hill. He lived right here in the Magnolia Hill section. What's his name? I can't think of his name right now. The first voice on WBCB. But boy, what a mellow voice he had. He only came on briefly, introduced himself, told the people what they would expect to hear today, which was not much except introductions of various people that were associated with the station. The manager, Jack Dash, I remember his name. He's the guy that hired me. He hired me down at the Ben Franklin Hotel in Philadelphia. We had lunch together, and I told him that I lived right in Fairless Hills, only 5 minutes away, and I had 6 years commercial experience with radio and TV, and I wanted a part-time job, and he said, hey, you got it. You got the experience. You're right in the neighborhood. Why not? I said, well, do you want to hear an audition? He says, oh, I hear your voice. You got a good voice, and we don't need an audition. And I was hired right at the spot. And I started on a show called the Johnny Come Lately Show, which was on the following Monday night from 7 to midnight, which was a little bit rugged because I couldn't handle with my regular job during the day a 7 to midnight swing. So we shortened it to 7 to 10. And I worked that way for about 2.5 or 3 years when I took a road territory with my full-time job and I had to give up the evening show. But that was not the end of the association. Although for a while I wasn't with the station, I came back and did a little bit of morning news with Bill Bercher. How I remember the Bercher. He's the only guy in radio, I think, that could actually break me up. I mean, I used to be sitting over there and doing the news, and he'd be sitting behind the microphone. And while I was reading the news, which was supposed to be done seriously, Bill Bercher would be there making all kinds of faces and grunts and everything to fill in. And he just really got to me. I thought he was a very funny guy, and I couldn't keep a straight face with him around. So with Bercher there, I had a tough time doing that show.
Serving all of Lower Bucks County, Pennsylvania, this is WBCB-AM, Levittown, Fairless Hills.
I'm Johnny Mack at 132. 18-year-old Anthony Paradiso of 20 Viking Lane in Falls Township escaped early Saturday morning from his family's burning house. Paradiso, who was home alone at the time of the fire, suffered only smoke inhalation. Falls Fire Chief Robert Hedden said the family room and storage room were gutted. Extensive smoke damage was caused throughout the Jubilee model house. A preliminary investigation by the Bucks County Fire Marshal's office shows the fire may have been caused by electrical problems. A Montgomery County judge says he'll rule on the legality of a threatened school strike in Norristown tomorrow if the teachers walk off the job. 435 teachers plan to return to the picket lines unless an agreement is reached with the Norristown Area School District. Unless White House and congressional negotiators can agree on a deficit reduction plan this week, automatic across-the-board spending cuts will kick in. House Republican leader Robert Michael tells NBC he thinks President Reagan might accept a compromise plan that includes Social Security cuts, but only as a last resort. A former president says there's a chance Cuomo might change his mind and run for the Democratic presidential nomination after all. Former President Jimmy Carter says indecisive early primaries could draw Cuomo into the race. We'll take a look at the weather right after this.
Who was the first? What you don't... What you don't know can hurt you and your car. It's a fact. And you should know, dirt and abrasives shorten the life of your engine. The solution is simple, however. Keep your car clean and it will last longer.
Lee Auto Supply, 6317 Westfield Avenue in Pensauken, New Jersey at 609-665-4901, have known this all along. That's why they recommend AC oil filters. They're designed to protect your gasoline engine from the harmful effects of dirt and abrasives for miles to come. And they stand up to the higher engine oil temperatures and pressures of today's cars. These AC oil filters fit practically all cars and light trucks, so use them today to help increase the life of your engine. Lee Auto Supply at 6317 Westfield Avenue in Pensauken, New Jersey. Phone 609-665-4901 and AC Oil Filters. Two names you can count on. Stay ahead of trouble with AC Delco.
One down.
I've always tried to feature the big band sounds. And I know that that didn't go over too well with the radio station in the beginning. They thought that we should have had a middle-of-the-road format, as they called it. But I kind of stuck with the big bands. I liked them. I thought the people out there were my age bracket, and they seemed to back me up on that, and it worked out pretty well. Now, the station promotes my big band shows on Sundays, so I have no problems with it. People out there like it. They're my age category, and it's too good to let sit on the shelf and gather dust, so I play it. And people seem to like it, and I seem to like it. People say, why would you want to tie yourself up every Sunday afternoon? It's a weekend off for your regular job. And I say, hey, this is my hobby. I love the big band sounds, and they pay me to play them, so why should I give it up? I love it. It's a labor of love, my paid hobby, as I call it. I don't know whether I should tell the boss that, but... Some of the early remembrances of WBCB, well, I can't help but remember the March snowstorm, and it occurred right around the first day of spring, if you people out there could recall. March the 17th or the 21st, I guess it would be closer to the 21st, 1958. We had only been on the air a couple of months, and we had this monstrous snowfall right on the first day of spring, and everybody was in shock. The place was all shut down, the power was off, and WBCB kept operating all the time. And we generally felt that that snowstorm put WBCB on the map because people became aware of us because They were in bad shape. I remember I brought my family up at that time. We had the kids at home. We stayed up at the station for a number of hours because we had no power and no heat at home. And we came up here and the kids played around in the radio station and had a ball. And the police were in touch with us and we were giving out their bulletins and people were told to tune into WBCB. They would have the local news about closings and emergency procedures. I mean, it was, I think it was around a 21-inch snowfall that we had then. It was just tremendous. But we made it through fine. And after that, people knew about WBCB because Mother Nature put us right on the map. Kind of hate to think that it took a real bad snowstorm to put us on the map, but at that point we'd take anything. And from there on in, like they say, it was all downhill because we just went from there to acceptance in the Lower Bucks community. And you people out there have been responsible for us being popular the way we are. If it weren't for your acceptance, there'd be no point in us being here. So we say thank you for putting WBCB on the map, because the listeners are, that's what it's all about. I can play this big band music anytime at home, and I do sometimes, but it's never as much fun as when I share it with people. That's the real fun.
This is WBCB, Levittown, Fairless Hills, Pennsylvania, where you can sound off on Speak Your Piece with Tom Early, 1210 till 1 p.m., Monday through Saturday.
Tom Early, a buddy of mine that started at WBCB the same day that I did. In fact, he and I are the only two now of the original members of the station that are still here. And I'm kind of proud of that, and I think Tom is too. I remember the first time I met Tom, he had a little more hair then, and so did I. But the thing that I remember about Tom was he was the kind of a fellow that the first time you met him, you liked him. I mean, he has that amazing quality of being so congenial and friendly and lovable. And maybe that's not a good word to use about it, but I mean, that's what he is. He is a lovable guy. You just can't help but love him. And he has this warm personality that once you meet him, you're his friend. That you just can't help it. And I have always admired Tom's ability to handle Speak Your Piece. I've not been able to do it myself. I couldn't control myself that well. But Tom always seems to keep his cool and handle everything so easily. I often sometimes wonder if it happens that he suffers from high blood pressure from keeping himself under control, when he certainly must be riled up at some time. He's human, he's gotta be, and yet he never seems to show it on the air. He's just an amazing guy. And I also remember the times when Tom used to have his Sunday morning record show. He gave that up a number of years ago. And I don't blame him, because I mean, he was short on time, and he certainly didn't need to do that show. He had plenty to do with his work and insurance and with what he did for the station off the air and on the air. So he did it for a while and then he gave it up. But when he was on the Sunday morning show, he played the kind of music that I liked, and it was kind of a nice lead-in to the big band sounds that I featured on Sunday afternoon. And I always figured that he's going to really help me get a lot of listeners, because he had a very listenable show. And I miss the fact that Tom isn't on Sunday, although I understand why he isn't.
Just a reminder that Speak Your Piece is on 6 days a week, Monday through Friday, done by your host Tom Riley, and Saturday, now done by Frank Foley. So tune in and talk about the things that you wish at 949-3232-295-3700.
Speak Your Piece was one of the original shows on WBCB, and it has been the longest running show of any radio station in the area that I know of. It just was a natural, it seemed like a natural thing to go on the air, and with somebody like Tom to MC it, they had a natural there too, and people immediately took it up, because it was a chance for people to really let us know and let everyone else know what their feelings were, whether they had a gripe or a pat on the head for somebody or something that had been bothering them for some time or a question of some sort. I just wonder how many hundreds and hundreds of people that Tom must have helped by getting them the information that they needed, or putting them in line to get the information that they needed. Tom doesn't know the answer to everything, obviously, any more than anybody else. But Tom had that gift of if he didn't know the answer, he pretty well knew how to get that person in line to get the right answer. It's the old story of, well, if I don't know the answer to that question, I'll find somebody that does. And that's the way Tom was. And Tom has not only the gift of the MC, but the gift of wanting to help people. And I think that's what people recognize about Tom. They know that this is a man who cares, and he does. Tom is just a special individual, and one that we hope will be around for a long, long time. Tom is only, I think Tom is 2 years younger than I am. We're not going to give out ages today. If the women can be a little bit sensitive about their ages, so can we men. But we'll never see 29 anymore, or 39, or 49, or 59.
1490 AM, WBCB, Cutter Captain radio program on Election Day, 1987 there. Let me be the clock. That, of course, is Smokey from a couple of years ago. On Wednesday, we'll be giving away a $200 gift certificate from Cochise Clothing in the Windsor Shopping Center in Levittown as part of our 30th anniversary, so be sure you're listening tomorrow and make sure you're registered to play tomorrow.
In the 1490 News headlines, Captain Frack will be along once again at 4 o'clock. The Morrisville Zoning Hearing Board says no to the Towpath high-rise towers. And the polls in Pensy are open until 8 p.m. tonight for today's general election. Don't forget to tune in tonight starting at 8:05 for the WBCB Election Night Returns. Elsewhere in the news, the Reverend Jerry Falwell has resigned as head of the Moral Majority to pursue what he says is his first love, full-time preaching. And he says he is no longer going to play an active role in political campaigns or lobby for religious causes. Captain Frank has details coming up once again at 4 o'clock. Time now to open the doors of WBCB's Doggone Department. If you have lost a pet, found a pet, or want to know of a pet being given away, stay tuned right now. I may mention it on the air. First of all, in the Lost Department, lost a female Airedale Poodle mix, tan and gray in color, and that was lost in the Oak Tree area. If you find that female Airedale Poodle mix, telephone the owner at 943-3799. Also lost a male Beagle-type dog. It's black and white in color, lost in the Indian Creek section. Telephone 945-6405 if by any chance you find that male Beagle-type dog black and white. In the Found Department, found a female German Shepherd found in Morrisville. If you've lost that animal, telephone 736-1428. Also found a female terrier-type puppy. It's black with a black spot on its back, found in the Bristol area. Telephone 943-2233 if by any chance you've lost that white with a black spot female terrier-type puppy. Also found a male golden retriever found in the Langhorne Trebos area. Telephone 322-1803 or 943-2388 if you've lost that male golden retriever. Found a female Keese Hound, silver gray and black in color, found at New Falls Road in Oxford Valley Roads. Telephone 547-3039 after 3:30 p.m. if you've lost a silver gray and black female Keese Hound. And found a female Airedale Terrier, found on South Broad Street in Trenton. Telephone area 609-397-2179 after 6 p.m. if you've lost a female Airedale Terrier. Also found a male Golden Retriever in Lower Southampton. Telephone 943-2388 if you've lost a male Golden Retriever. Also found a male black and tan Doberman puppy wearing a collar. That was found in the Junewood section. Telephone 949-1151 if you've lost a male black and tan Doberman puppy wearing a collar. And found a male Doberman, black and brown in color, found in the Bristol area. Telephone 785-1290 if you've lost a black and brown male Doberman. Wanted a good home for a male neutered silver tabby cat. It's been declawed. If you're interested, telephone 943-2779. And if you have a lost dog in the Bristol Barrow area, contact the Bristol Barrow Police Department. Dog On is heard Monday through Saturday at 9:45 in the morning, 3:45 in the afternoon, and 8:45 in the evening. If you have lost a pet, found a pet, or have one to give away, phone WBCB Radio during business hours, 9 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. Monday through Friday, and tell us about your pet. And when your pet problems have been taken care of, don't forget to notify BCB once again. 3:49 on the Cutter Captain Show, 11 in front of 4 on a cloudy Tuesday election day, and here from Shadow Traffic once again to cast his vote for what's happening out on the highways, it's Jim Battle East. I try to make it a little election-like, you know, Jim?
I can remember a lot of of personalities here at WBCB. Some of them are with us and some aren't. I can remember a lot of broadcasts that we did in football in the early days. Fred Finger was my associate on the football games, and Paul Nini worked with me on football too. And I've often told this story, and it never ceases to amuse me, and it might amuse the people out there. Paul Nini and I were working a football game over at Council Rock in the early days. This was before Council Rock had their real nice stadium up there in Newtown. They had a very quivering platform set on four steel rods, and we had to climb up a ladder and get up there. And when we got up there, we were kind of like balancing on a high wire. It was kind of scary in a way. But at any rate, we started the game, and it was one of those typical fall evenings, a night game. The lighting wasn't all that great. Excuse me. And the fog started to move in, as it often does in the fall, in the evening. You know, the cold air comes moving in. And the first thing you know, the fog came down over the football field, and we could hardly follow the play-by-play. The fellow would get the ball on this side of the field, that was okay, but if he'd run toward the other side of the field, he ran out of sight. We couldn't follow him. And it was so bad that it became funny. I began to laugh and break up, and I couldn't go on anymore with the broadcast, and Paul Nini took it up like a real trooper, and the first thing you know, I guess my laughing got him to laughing, and the first thing you know, both of us were laughing almost out of control. In fact, we were. Well, we finally got control of ourselves and the ball game and finished it okay. And we were kind of embarrassed with what happened because, you know, you're not supposed to do that professionally. But I kind of felt good about Sunday because I had a call from a lady who said that she heard the broadcast on Friday, I guess it was a Friday night, and she said, you know, I had one of the biggest laughs I've had in a long time just at you characters laughing at the football game. She said, I thought it was one of the funniest things I've ever heard. And I said, well, gee, thank you, man, because that makes me feel a lot better because I shouldn't have done what I did, but I couldn't help it. And she said, oh, well, I think that's what occurred to everybody to be funny when you lost control. So that really made me feel a lot better about what happened at the football game.
Hello, this is Speak Your Piece. Who's this? Harold Kistner, you're on the phone. All right. Hey, it's good to have you with us.
That proves I listen, right?
That proves you listen. Congratulations to Harold Kistner. What are your feelings right now, Harold, now that you have won that trip to Hawaii?
Very happy. Never been there, so I'm looking forward to it.
You've never been there. Are you going to go alone? Do you have somebody to go with you? I'd love to go along.
I better take my wife.
Oh, I guess you'd better. I was going to offer to go along and carry your suitcases. Tell me, have you been a listener to WBCB for a long time?
Oh, yeah.
You have, huh?
50 or 30 years.
And what is your address, Harold?
2841 Stanwood Lane.
2841 Stanwood Lane, that's in Bensalem, right?
Right.
All right. Well, our congratulations.